You are watching Yay or Nay Reviews, where we take 2 minutes to answer one question. Should you see it?
The Hunger Games, based on the best-selling novels by Suzanne Collins, takes place in a future North America, now known as Panem. Panem is divided into 13 poor districts and the wealthy capital. Now, long, long ago, District 13 decided it had enough of being oppressed and decided to rise on up, but got smacked back down, like really smacked back down, wiped off the map, smacked back down. So because of this uprising, the capital has devised the Hunger Games. Every year, they take one boy and one girl from each district aged 12 through 18 as tributes. And they drop these 24 kids into an arena and make them fight to the death in front of the entire world. Our heroine of the story is Katniss Everdeen, brilliantly brought to life by Jennifer Lawrence. Katniss is this year's female tribute from District 12 and an all-around badass. I mean, she's not supposed to be a warm and fuzzy character, but you are supposed to feel for her, something that Jennifer Lawrence did brilliantly. Our male tribute is Peeta Mellark, played by Josh Hutcherson, who, to be honest, I was a little skeptical about. Journey to the Center of the Earth 2, you did not help matters. But to be honest, he just is Peeta. I mean, he's so natural and genuine in the role, I can't imagine anybody else playing him. Unlike in the books, Haymitch, the tribute's mentor, has a much smaller role here, but Woody Harrelson still does a fabulous job bringing him to life. Stanley Tucci as Caesar and Elizabeth Banks as Effie Trinket were also great standouts. One of the great things this movie does is how they convey information. The book is told completely from Katniss's point of view, and I was really worried that this would mean voiceover. But if there's something the audience needed to know about, for instance, tracker jackers, they would just switch back to the commentators. I mean, The Hunger Games is basically like a sporting event, and the film really used that to its advantage. Obviously, the movie can't be as in-depth, so for instance, the cave scenes are a lot shorter in the movie than they are in the book. While disappointing, it's understandable, they can't put everything from the book into the movie. And even with some things shorter or left out, it's still pretty spot on. And once again, I'm reviewing something I'm obsessed with. I've read the books, I went to the midnight showing, cried, and was exhausted afterwards. What does that tell you? The books, yay. The movie, yay. Overall, The Hunger Games, a huge yay. What did you think? What was the best part of seeing The Hunger Games brought to life from the books? Sound off in the comments below or join the discussion over on our website, shouldyouseeit.com. And while you're in a video watching mood, watch these reviews of similar movies. At least watch my Harry Potter review. Happy movie going.